In this video, we're going to give you some advice about getting the best out of your new binoculars. That really starts right from the get-go with unpacking your binocular and your first use of it. Now, of course, we know you're going to be raring to go to unpack your new binocular and get it going, but just a word of advice really about that. Like a lot of people, you're probably going to unpack your binocular in your kitchen and then set it up, and you're going to be very eager to start using it. And you're likely to stumble into a problem in using the binocular straight away. When you first get the binocular and get it out of the packaging and start looking at, you're going to be looking at the binocular. So your eyes are not really going to be ready for actually looking through the binocular, because you're spending an awful lot of your time looking at it. You're probably going to be indoors, and your first view is actually going to be maybe out the kitchen window or something like that. You're never going to get a good view with the binocular, and it's not really going to give you any indication of just how good the binocular can be. So take an extra few seconds and maybe open the front door and look outside with it. And also, and this is a good tip for the future, actually practice not looking at the binocular. So when you're comfortable with the controls, always make sure that your eye is actually in contact on the target. So look over the top of the binocular, and this is how you're going to use it actually when you're bird watching or wildlife watching or looking for your target, your shipping, whatever you're going to be doing. Look at the target, fix on the target, and then lift the binocular into that view. And again, when you take the binocular away from your eye, fix on the target. Don't look at the binocular. If you're looking at the binocular, you're looking at a very, very close range target. Your eye is then going to be trying to look at infinity when you actually look through the binocular. So there's going to be quite a jolt going on there. So always remember that tip. Look at the target, lift the binocular into the view. One of the first things you're going to want to do with the binocular is make an adjustment for the diopter setting. Now, all modern binoculars are equipped with an independent diopter setting. You can find it usually very easily on the right-hand eyepiece of your binocular. You'll typically see a knurled ring like this. It'll look different to the left-hand eyepiece. Very often, you'll see something like this as well. You'll actually see numbers presented on the diopter ring, and sometimes arrows or a plus and minus sign. Now, the independent diopter adjustment is actually going to enable you to make an adjustment for your personal eyesight. It's also going to allow you to make a small adjustment for any mechanical uncertainties in the design of the binocular as well. So that's actually a very useful way of making sure that both eyes are presented with a fully focused view every time you make an adjustment to the focusing knob. But before you do that, you'll need to familiarise yourself with the design of eye cup on your binocular. It's important that you get the eye cup setting correctly, otherwise you're not going to get a fully illuminated, full field of view out of your binocular. Now, the eye cup design may vary on your binocular from the ones that we're showing you here, but typically it's going to be some kind of mechanism or device that enables you to move the eye cup relative to the optics of the eyepiece. So, for example, if you're a glasses wearer like me, you'll want these eye cups in the down position. We want them in the down position to make sure that the optics of the eyepiece are as close as we can possibly get them to the eye, even with our prescription eyewear in place. If you're not an eyeglass wearer, then you'll want your eye cups in the out position. The exact position you might want might vary slightly if your eye cups have got more than one position, but be sure to look at your binocular to see, even if they don't screw, you may find that the eye cups actually fold down. I don't know whether you can see that, Drew, if I do this. There we go, the eye cups actually fold down to get you that same effect as the screw design that we're seeing on these other binoculars here. Let's show you how to make that diopter adjustment to your binocular now. Be useful if you've got one of the caps handy. You can do it without the cap, just by blocking off the tube with your hand. Place the cap on the side of the binocular where the independent diopter adjustment is, and pick out a target that's perhaps 100 meters away, somewhere in the middle distance, not too far and not too close. Take a look at that target, take a look at it. Bring the binocular up to your eye and make an adjustment of the focus. That's on the main focuser of the binocular, not the independent eyepiece. Make an adjustment to the main focuser, get it as sharp as you can. Now simply transfer the cap onto the other tube of the binocular, the one you've just been focusing up. And now, looking at the same target, make an adjustment of the independent diopter adjustment on the eyepiece. Get that as sharp as you can. Now remove the cap and just check the focus point again. If you've got any contest at all or anything you're not comfortable with, just simply repeat the process by putting the cap back onto the right hand side. Make the adjustment with the central focuser. When you've got it sharp, move the cap over onto the left hand side. Make the adjustment with the independent diopter control. Just check it one more time. Make sure you're getting a good view. Now, every time you use the binocular, both sides will be automatically focused at the same time, simply by adjusting the central diopter control. You might like to also make a note of your setting now of your binocular. Take a note of where the arrow is relative to the numbers or the plus and minus sign, because if you do observe with anyone else and they make any adjustment to your binocular, you can very easily restore the binocular back to your personal setting. Another thing that sometimes confuses people is the bridge setting of your binocular. That's the binocular's ability to actually bend like this, or on this hinge point down the middle of the binocular, to make an adjustment for the distance between your eyes, your interpupillary distance. It's important that you get that right. Hollywood is used to showing us views through a binocular that looks something like this, and that's really just to convince you that the hero is actually using a pair of binoculars, when in actual fact we should be looking for a view something like this, a single fused stereoscopic view. Now you're going to get that by actually making that adjustment to the binocular and making sure that you see a good fully illuminated view through each side of the binocular, and that really is just a matter of making sure that the binocular width is exactly the same as your eyes. Let's just talk very briefly about neck straps. That's actually a pretty important part of the binocular. We'd really recommend that you get the neck strap attached to your binocular as quickly as you can after you receive it, because it's really the neck strap that's going to provide you with a lot of the safe handling of the binocular. We'd always recommend that you keep the neck strap around your neck when you're using the binocular out in the field, and you're even going to find that just having the neck strap in place makes it 10 times more likely that if you do have an accidental conflict with gravity, you're actually going to be able to grab something rather than just the binocular. So this gives you a lot of chance to actually save your rather nice binoculars from making contact with the ground. While we're talking about neck straps, just take a look at rain guards. Rain guards are a great idea. They can be attached to the eye cups of your binocular while you've got them hanging around your neck, and obviously they're going to stop rain falling on the eyepieces and stop you using the binocular. You'll notice that the rain guard has been attached onto one side. Now, we actually get rather a lot of calls. A lot of rain guards have this split link on the other side. A lot of people phone up and say, oh, I've got a broken one here. It's actually been cut through. Well, it's actually been designed like that. And it's made that way so that when you put the rain guard on the binocular, you can actually connect your strap through that split, and it holds everything in place. In actual fact, I find with my binoculars, I don't really need to bother doing that. It actually holds itself in place perfectly fine without this extra little refinement on the edge here. Anyway, that's just a very simple explanation of how that actually works. And finally, just a brief word about cleaning and maintenance of your binocular. There is no routine maintenance for you to perform on the modern binocular, but you might want to clean the optics from time to time. We'd really suggest you only do that on a need basis, if you actually see something that specifically needs cleaning off the binocular. We'd really recommend a studied negligence of the binocular to a certain degree when it comes to cleaning. It really doesn't need anything. Don't fuss with it. Don't clean it unnecessarily. If you do see grease deposits and things like that on the front lens, the objectives, do be careful when you're cleaning, because very good modern binoculars often have very deep, rather fragile coatings on the front lenses. So definitely be cautious there about how you do the cleaning. Equip yourself with an anti-static cleaning solution, some good wood-free lens cleaning tissues, maybe cotton buds as well. This is an ideal device. It's a microfiber cleaning cloth, and definitely a little blower brush. You can usually get all of these components in a kit. The Astronomy and Nature Centre, we stock various versions of this kind of thing, all of which are suitable, and they're only a few pounds. Before you commence any cleaning at all on the binocular, always use the blower brush first, just to make sure that there are no gritty deposits or dust particles that might harm the coating of the binocular when you start doing any other cleaning activity. So certainly always start off by using the blower brush. Cleaning grease spots and things like that off, at the very most, moisten a cotton bud with the cleaning solution and just gently tease the grease off the surface before finally polishing it dry using the lens cleaning tissue or the microfiber cleaning cloth. You can be a little bit more robust with your cleaning on the eyepiece end of the binocular, and there you are more likely to encounter grease and that kind of thing, because obviously we're putting this close to our face, so you're likely to have moisture from the surface of your skin, grease, possibly even makeup that the ladies have used around their eyes and that kind of thing. And that could actually build up on the eyepieces in such a way that it could actually be deleterious to the performance of the binocular. So it is worth giving that a clean up. The good news is most well-made binoculars have got fairly hard coatings on the eyepiece, so you can be a little bit more liberal in your cleaning there and the regularity of the cleaning without doing any harm. That's it for this video. Hope that was useful. Bye for now.